we can start putting the work in place to concentrate these tailings, clean up the environment, put local folks to work, and then supply these elements that are necessary for everyday lives, national security, and really, you know, national independence.
All right, welcome back inside our proactive newsroom. And joining me now is Kirk Taylor. He is the Chief Financial Officer for American Resources Corp. And Kirk, it's great to see you again. How are you?
Yeah, you too, Steve. We're good. We've been super busy over the past few days. So appreciate you taking the moment here to chat with us.
Yeah, lots to talk about. First off, we should talk about this $33 million financing. It just leapt off the page for everyone. So tell me a little bit about how this was all put together.
Yeah, absolutely. So we were approached by two fundamental investors who have been investing in a critical mineral and rare earth space for a while. They've been following what American Resources has been doing, and they thought the time was right to put some fuel behind all of our progress. So really appreciative to have them in our cap table, and looking forward to working with them in the future.
And Kirk, is this sort of the money that you need is to continue the growth and expansion that you're doing right now? I know that there's a lot of work in the new plant and in the old plant. It seems to be work everywhere.
Yeah, that's right. Our team is very busy, but we're very, very glad to have a great team. So now the ReElement has two fundamental long-term customers in Vulcan Elements and possibly International. American Resources needs to hustle to get the feedstock available to turn it into rare earth oxides for these orders. And thankfully, we have 100 years of coal tailings within our portfolio to start working on. And now that we have these, you know, foundational customers, we can start putting the work in place to concentrate these tailings, clean up the environment, put local folks to work, and then supply these elements that are necessary for everyday lives, national security, and really, you know, national independence.
I know there's been a lot of announcements from the company about the work that you're doing with all of your partners. Are you getting calls on a daily basis of people that are interested in more of the technology and how it works and how you can move what they do forward?
Yeah, we have a really good scientific team led by our CTO at ReElement, Yi-Ding, Dr. Yi-Ding. He has great staff, and they're often given new challenges brought to us by potential partners, and they rise to the occasion every time. A lot of things that we're working on, some that we've announced, but all very exciting.
Yeah. You're also about to head out on the road as well to kind of tell the ReElement story, because it is a fascinating one from everywhere, from New York to Korea. Yeah. You're going to be all over the place.
San Francisco as well, on a TDK Ventures top 100 tech opportunities invited us to come. It's been a whirlwind. We have to be really judicious with our time, and we're really thankful for the opportunity to be in front of partners, potential partners, investors. We think it's really important to be upfront and honest and transparent. So through conversations with yourself, we're also very appreciative of that. Excited to talk about how collectively we can solve some of these really challenging supply chain issues.
And I would imagine that some of these companies may be hearing about you for the very first time and understanding what this technology can do and the processes behind it, especially when you go into like Korea and places like that. They need this type of technology. It's important.
It is 100% up until now controlled by, you know, countries that had adversarial thoughts against the free world. And so having a foundational technology that is operational is a big differentiator. We can have partners or potential partners give us material. We can process it and turn it into usable material that they can test. So we take theory, you know, we take something that in practice would be a theory and turn it into actual practical application, which we think separates us from other, you know, opportunities out there.
Absolutely. Well, Kirk, congratulations on all this. It's going to be busy on the road, but you've got some cash in the bank, which is always important. And we'll talk again soon, okay?
Awesome. Appreciate your time, everybody.
All right. There's Kirk Taylor, the CFO of American Resources Corp.